Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Friday, our third webinar this week, to give you a look into, well, how I see the market. And we already did two webinars, had some very positive results. Very happy with that. Today I had a technical problem with Chrome. It was lagging very much only on TradingView. Very weird. Was dealing some time with it, and that's why I messed up a little bit my preparations. I have my list from last webinar, and well, maybe we can take some extra coins later on. We will see. Let us first start with the general market view. Sometimes I'm a bit distracted because somehow I still have to give entrance to the viewers. I thought I had cleared that, but when I'm a bit distracted, then somebody's knocking, and then I have to give them a permission to get in. Let's start with Bitcoin. What is this? Somebody else taking over? This is weird. I think my connection lost. Okay. That's very annoying that I have to give entrance to the people. But we'll start. Bitcoin. A little bit of stress this morning, some people. When I woke up, I saw that it was going down a bit. Read this, but I saw this line as an ABC, ABC. And I also posted it on Twitter that I thought this should be a bouncing area. It went a little bit down, more down, but it was more or less perfect on the trend line channel. I must say, sometimes it also surprises me how the predictions work. But well, it's a good bounce. Looks very healthy to me. People, please don't start asking now for charts or of your favorite coin or your bag. I will take a look at it maybe at the end, but please don't disturb the chat with chart requests. In the bigger picture for Bitcoin, I'm still bullish. Why not? I see this area as the first target. This is smaller channel. Maybe we'll get some little correction here. Could be something here, but this is the first area for me to what I see as a target on our way to 6K. Might be very well that if we get a correction here, like this. You see, I always draw ABC patterns because they are the most, you see them the most in the market nowadays. Pretty, very standard ABC. You see them a lot. But yeah, we might get a test here for this trend line and then back up. And as long as we stay above this yellow trend line, I'm bullish. And I don't see any reasons to change my view. Even when I look now, I also see this looks more like a same line. But as you might have noticed, I'm not that strict on lines. I don't see them as a support or resistance line. It's a zone. Don't forget that. It's a zone for me where something can happen. Hoopla. This trend line is not a support line for me. It doesn't mean that is automatically going to bounce here. It's just a zone where I expect some action. If it goes down here, then it depends on what kind of pattern. If you look at this pattern, for instance, that was a trend reversal pattern for me, like here. And when I see a coin or the price going like this, then I know that I can expect a bounce, and it happens. And so then I know that around this area, somewhere in this zone, I can expect the bounce, and it can be here or here, but it will bounce for me. And 9 out of 10, it works. And when I see a different pattern, a bearish pattern, then I'm very watching it, very much watching it, checking it if it drops down. And especially on the bigger view, when that happens around this line, then it's for me a sign that we are leaving the bullish trend. But for now, absolutely no reason to have any concerns. For me, I see a lot of bearish Elliott Wave traders on TradingView who still are saying that we are still going down. They said it here, they said it here and here, that we should collapse to 3,000 or 2,200. It's still not collapsing, guys. And those posters on TradingView, I see them now posting that, yeah, they have the possibility in their setup that they are still right, because they said that it could also go up. Yeah, I can laugh about it. No meaning, no harsh word about other traders, but that's typically for Elliott Wave. There are so many rules and restrictions, and there are always so many options to go. That's someone who is following that is always right, and that's not the way I like to work. It makes it all too complicated. Keep it simple. That's my motto. And it works for me. I hope that you can learn a bit. Well, that's Bitcoin. Not much to say. Just having good times here. Let me see. Yeah, I think a little bit more up, down, up. And what I said, 4,600 is my first target. Ethereum also made the same correction. Left this small up channel, that's a 1 hour, but yeah, it's not that dramatic, because I can see, when I see this pattern coming, I see this is an A, B, C, and it will go up again. Not sure what, well, maybe it's, we should have this line, not really. Well, like I said, I'm expecting this. And then more up. Oh, that's very small. you might get something like this. I also posted this on TradingView. This is an important area. Previous stops. It's a line from previous stops. And you can see here, this is my target. You might see another correction here. It's maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then again, some correction. And then this move. Not sure if it happens. I don't have a crystal ball, but this is the option, the scenario, what is most logic for me at the moment. Because it broke a previous stop here, this stop. So it makes the way, the road open to go here to test this zone. We'll have some correction, I think, before breaking and then up. Litecoin. You see, again. Guys, if you have problems with audio, maybe you can rejoin. Sometimes it helps. Litecoin, same again. ABC from last night. People panicked about some Korean news. But yeah, I'm not that much interested in Korea. The only fact is that my ex-wife is from Korea, but but otherwise I'm not interested in Korea and their exchanges. It caused a lot of it caused some FUD and some panic, but in the end this is just a very normal ABC correction. You see 1, 2, 3 let's see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see, you have an ABC here, you have here an ABC, and it's normal. We don't go in one straight line to the target. We will always have corrections, and funny enough, when I expect a correction, then later on there is news or bad news or FUD, and people start panicking because exchanges are closing or countries are banning altcoins or ICOs, and it's just a normal correction. What was already in the cards, and we need those corrections to ensure that, for instance, the RSI is cooling down. And we're going back up now. And look, very nice. That's a very nice move. Let me see. And I had also this move predicted, and what already looked pretty much. It was a while ago, in August or so, or something. Boom. And even went higher. And made A, B, C correction. And now we are starting back up again. And here, this is the previous stop we cleared, I think, yesterday. This one. Yeah. And that's also pretty standard move. When a previous stop is cleared, that you'll get a correction. This is more or less double top, but for me it's okay. Because I see the same movements in Ethereum and Bitcoin, and Litecoin will follow. But maybe too difficult. So we go to some other altcoins. I worked this list just in 15 minutes before start, because what I said, I had troubles with Chrome and I couldn't chart well. And I did this in a rush just before the meeting started, and maybe I'll have to adjust a bit later on. But then you can watch live. What we have in ADEX, ADEX made a nice move up. It's now in a correction, and this is going back up. This is bullish for me. Looking at the target. So if you want to trade this, wait for the breakout. And we have seen it so many times already this week. Breakout followed by a correction. When this goes like that, don't jump in here. Wait, because it will come back. It will make a correction, and because RSI will be overbought, and it needs to cool down. And for sure, it will come back. And then you just watch the pattern, it's coming then, and then you wait for a next breakout or a strong bounce. When you see a strong bounce, then you can also hop in. But never chase such candles. You saw this one. People maybe hopped on here. And you see it corrected. It didn't go back all the way, but this is a very nice chance to get in again. Not that much spectacular. This is a smaller 5 legs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, making an AUC now and going up. ARK. I'm a little bit disappointed in ARK. I was following this for a long time, making an ABC correction. First, I was thinking that it could bounce around this area, and it did. Here was my trend line first. I think this was my trend line first. Yeah, something like that. And it bounced very nice here and suddenly dropped. I don't know why. I see here a corrective down move. So I'm not that worried. This will break up again. I would be worried if I saw around this zone, if I would see these kind of candles, these big candles. That is an impulsive move. But you see here, let me go back to a smaller time frame. This is an impulsive move, what is creating a new trend. You see here a very long corrective move, and that's going slowly down, down, down. And I bought here again. I saw the breakout here and even going back up in the uptrend. And suddenly it fell down again, but still pretty slow. So I'll wait. I don't know the reason why it's going down, but I'm just could go even till here. But I was also too late with selling at entry price, and then suddenly it went down here, and then I thought, well, if it's at 60, 65, this is more or less my target area, then I'll keep it, and I'll buy more in this area because I have good feelings about ARK. BAT, we had an up move, deep correction, and this, like I said, this is a perfect example. If you chase these candles, look, it's coming back, it's testing the trend line. I already mentioned that many times this week. Retest of the trend line is very common. It made here a bullish pattern, broke out again, and look again. Don't chase candles, it's coming back. It's testing the trend line, and it should go up now. Normally, it should go up now. I'm on 4 hour, let me see, on 1 hour. Yeah, it's a good bounce. You see, I see here a trend reversal pattern. Yeah, I don't, if I go back to the 15, I could draw it. Let me see. Yeah, it's more or less this. So I wouldn't be surprised if we see a little bit more hesitating before this. And where are we heading to? Let me see. Oops. Well, oh, come on. No, not okay. We start here. First leg up, correction. This is leg two, second leg. Now we're starting the third leg here. We'll see a correction here and then going up more. Deckard is the example what I told you earlier this week that I said that I don't want to buy here. Too much risk because it's in the middle of a channel. It was here something I think that I said it can go up, but I won't buy because the profit to here is for me too small compared to the risk. The risk is to the setup is invalid if you leave this trend line, and if you buy here, you have to be cautious because it can go back to here and still be in the uptrend. And you see it happening now. It's going here. And if it goes up again here, there's nothing wrong. But I will buy here, not here. I must say that I'm a bit surprised that my example of earlier this week is working now. It's a good example that you shouldn't buy in the middle of a channel. It's way too risky. Edgeless, more or less same story as ARK, unexpected fall for me. Well, I said, remember, I said this week that this is a trend reversal because you have a strong up move and then loss of momentum. We're still going up, but it's not anymore with this power and it's going slowly up. And then I said that it could make a correction, and it was a bit more as expected, but it's more or less to the previous bottom you see here. And now it looks like it wants to break out. You see, if you get a big green candle here, buy it because it's going up. If you miss it, wait for the correction. Correction is like this, maybe a retest, but I don't know, could happen. Or you wait for a consolidation. And what is a consolidation? It's when it's going up and then you see some flat candles, then you can easily put a limit buy that when it goes up, that you buy here. If you are not in the opportunity to stay focused on your screen, could almost say put in an automatic order, because when it breaks then again, it's going up. Game credits, I posted this for you on Twitter. I said this morning that we had a bounce here. This was my bouncing area, and it just made a nice big up move. Out breakout, I mean. And you see now correcting a bit. If I go to the 15, you will see the RSI. You see here, yeah, it's too high. It's going back a bit. It needs to cool down before it can go up again. Now, if I look here at the 50 minutes, I can see coming a pattern. What will be, I think, something like this. This is A, B, C. That's happening here. I think, or something like this. You will see, guys. This will go like this. And if you miss this, keep watching this and for the next up move, because I have pretty high expectations where it's going. We're now at 58. This is 78.80. Let me see. Yeah, I think this is just the first leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Might be very good possible from here to here. This. Lisk fell down more than I expected. I'm fighting with my lines today. you see? Come on, go away. I told you this week that I was looking at this and was not too worried. Now, let me say different. This is the normal pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I explained this week that I'm expecting a lot of news from Lisk and that a breakout would be very good possible. But we saw a breakout to the downside. And it surprised me. But this is an ABC. Not sure if it's already finished. But now we have to watch. If you are in Lisk, watch what it's going to do here. If it's making a bear flag, if it goes a little bit like this, then you might expect a further downfall. If it now bounces strong, then it might do like this. But be prepared for continuation of more or less the same pattern. And that might be very well something like this. I don't know. But look here. It did the same here. It was a drop of, I think, more or less, somebody told me 60% or something. Might be very well happening again, and although there's lots of news coming, maybe the news is coming later, or maybe you'll get saved by the news. But on the charts, if you only look at the charts, then it's saying that it's going down, as long as it's not cracking this line again. Some people still having problems, I see, with audio or the view. please just try to rejoin. Many times it already helps. Monaco, yeah, it's in my list, but it shouldn't be anymore because nothing to see. This will go sometime, but when? I don't know. This might be a flat even. If this is a flat, yeah, well, it's coming from down, then it's making a flat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then up. But that could take some time. NEO, interesting. We had a nice up move. I think yesterday, day before yesterday, then a correction, but it's still very normal. And it just touched the bouncing area, going up again. Then the Korean news dropped back in the bouncing area. And yeah, it looks like magic. It's touching, retesting the trend line again and bouncing. And really, sometimes I'm also surprised that it works over and over again, that you see it so much. If you're not in here, if you didn't buy here, wait for this to make a little bit more. It could be enough from here. Very simple. Cracking this line. Bye. Oh, wait. You want to know where we are heading to? This is the first target. That is 100, more or less. And we are now at 70. So that's 40% trade. That's not bad at all. And this is the bigger picture. We had a 1, 2, and then the big pump a few weeks ago. What? That's even 2 months ago. We had a big pump to here, a very deep correction, but still all very normal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's going to happen. Trust me. Is there any form of support here? No, it's not. I see I'm losing about 15-20 people now. There's still maybe a little bit of connection problems. But this is the bigger picture for NEO, guys. You see, 150, beautiful. If you can pick it here, it would be nice. If it goes here, it would be great. Expect a correction here. And then the next line. OKCash. I don't know this one really good. Just somebody asked. And you see a long retrace here, breakout, and again correcting. And this is why many times it's good to buy after the breakout. Because you had here the breakout, you could have bought here, but then you see a pretty long correction. Just wait for the breakout here. Because this is bullish. OMG. I told you this week that I'm not that enthusiastic about the chart for OMG. And, well, we had some, I don't know what, but we had some good news here. But look at this. It fell back down in the channel more or less. This is very hesitant. And this is a weird drop. This was because of the Korean news. I don't know, OMG is not Korean, I'm not sure, but like I said this week, I'm not into the fundamentals of every coin. I never check them. I'm just looking at my charts. But I know that OMG is from somewhere in Asia, and maybe that's why they reacted so hard on the news. But then I see a bounce, but it's not convincing me. And what you see now is, again, it's falling down. And because this is a bear flag, very clear for me. And that's for me the sign that it's going more down. And it's also, this is more or less, it's back in this pattern, the blue lines. And it's bouncing off this zone, so it might go deeper. You see, this is what I draw earlier this week. Not sure if no, because we have an higher. Yeah. Could be something like this. NXP, big rise few last week, I think, was it? Yeah. And this is a correction. This is more or less the same what we saw on a smaller time frame on Deckard. Am I right? Where did I see it? No. You see this? This pattern, you can see it here also. So it might go a bit more up and up, and it will correct. Up move, and now loss of momentum. You see here, pretty high RSI on the 4 hour, so that needs to correct. It's high, it's still high, and it's going back now a bit. And I wouldn't be surprised if this drops a bit more. Yeah, good. Machine 1, 2, 3. Maybe till here or something. Quantum resistance Fletcher. Nice pump. Deep retrace. Poor man's pump. Bad news, Korea. And this looks also as if it could. It's not convincing, huh? You see? If you draw a line here, what does it look for you? You see here. Strong candles down, trying to go up, but it's not going up. And for me, this feels like these candles are pushing on this line and trying to push it away and so that the price can go down. And I'm very, how can I say that? And I'm looking for patterns and try to make a story of it. Like I say, this feels for me that it just feels that is going down, and then it for me it's very very logical that this is going down, and because I also practice these patterns a lot, but for me it's now more or less I have it in my I'm imagining that this is pushing down that line, and it will fall down. Or the dev is awake, or the dev is watching this webinar and he's bringing out some good news later this afternoon. But normally, if we go up, if we think about the normal pattern, then it should go down. SafeX. I was also expecting more upside, but this brought the price below this trend line. It tried to get up. I mean, you see what I said before, that if you have an up move, that it is doing a retest, you'll see it again here. It's breaking down. Retesting the trend line, failing and going down further, but not that hard anymore as here. So that might mean that drop slowly till here, or maybe sometime earlier that it will go up. Patiently, they're breaking out. So grab your bitcoins and go buy. Because there's a lot of room. You see? From 110 to 180 at least, should be doable. And why? Because I see this. Up move, correction till here, bottoming out, and now here again a bullish pattern and breaking out of that bullish pattern. VIA is coming with lots of news. I already told it in the previous webinars. Buy it, hold it, and celebrate it, because it will work. I almost never gave a guarantee, and I'm doubting to give a guarantee here, but I won't do it. But this will go for sure. Breakout, retest, and it's now in a small flat. If I look at this flat, normally this is a bearish flat correction, because it's coming from up, bouncing, correcting, and it could go here. And I would just say, if it breaks out here or here, buy it. If it makes another down move, then it's very likely that it goes like this. But if it goes more down, try to find the bottom, because if you can buy it now still for 20, then it's a dream. If it goes this deep, I'm certainly gonna buy more. I'm already pretty much loaded, but if it goes more down, I'm buying. And I know that the developer for VIA is currently working on atomic swaps. He's already teasing us on Twitter. So knowing him a bit, I think that I wouldn't be surprised if he will announce that it works today or tomorrow, and then there will be a pump. What's happening here? Nice candle. Some formal buying. Is that because somebody here said waves is breaking out and you all go by? Come on, don't do that, man. I'm already tracking waves for some longer time, I think, from here. I bought here somewhere, I bought here when I saw this breaking out. Correcting a bit more as expected, but then I saw the pattern coming. It was more this bouncing area, and it went all the way down in the bouncing area. Then I saw this bounce coming, and I bought again here, and this is a nice example of a consolidation after breakout. You see, this is just some flat candles. This is called a consolidation. And it's breaking out again. And this will go. I think that waves will make a new all-time high in the coming weeks. Might take a bit longer. This was a 38%, 38 Bitcoin buy. Oh, that's not bad. I never understand those people. I wanted to show the bigger picture. You see, we are just on the beginning of a big breakout. One leg up, one leg down, second leg up, maybe a third leg down, and fifth leg. Come on, guys, buy this. There is so much good developments for waves coming. This is certainly going hard. I can't guarantee that it's going to happen today or tomorrow, but buy it and look back in December, January, for sure. Elastic. And also, again, showing weird moves. This just looks as if it is falling back again in this pennant. And then you'll just have to wait for a new breakout. Yeah. One, two, three, maybe two here. And then hope for a new breakout. I don't expect much from Ripple. No, there is nothing to see. This is what I said earlier this week. It's going down here, or first one more leg up, and then it's going down. Pretty clear for me. Or we'll get some heavy news, new developments, but I don't expect it. Perch is trying to break out of this flat, and once it happens, it's going here. It's listed today, I think, on Binance. Oh, Binance. Let me look at another one. We'll look at the Walton coin later on. It's I can't chart it anywhere, so we'll have to do it with a pretty standard chart from Binance. But it's very interesting coin to watch. Let's finish this first. Zero Zcoin. Yeah, it made a correction here, broke out, and not showing real direction right now. It's showing direction. You see, big down move, up move, but not like this. This might make another correction down. Let me see how far. Yeah, back in the blue box, maybe. Or we get a strong bounce here, but I wouldn't be surprised if this is going, it's going to correct more. Is that a problem? No, not for me. If it's going down more, I'll just buy more. But I think this correction maybe just wasn't enough and we'll make this correction. Come on. A, B, C. This. And your lines will be more like this. See? And then it's time to make this. Because you still have here a pretty big one, but this is a bullish pattern, a bullish flag. Up move, correction, up move. So this might take another week or 2 weeks before we see some real action. Is it on 2 October, Binance, for Verge? Okay. Zero cash. I made some fun about it on Twitter. It was not meant to be mean, but I saw so many people yesterday, experienced traders, saying that they bought a dip and they sold here and bought a dip and they were very proud. And then I see this. Boom. Irish flag. This one. Correcting this one. This is going down. Yeah. If I'm wrong, come and tell me. Come and tell me next week in our Market Watch. Get yourself being a member and tell me when I'm wrong. But I think this is retracing more. Because when I look at the fundamentals, what I know about it is that this is a insider buying because of a listing on a Korean exchange or Japanese exchange, I don't know. This was insider buying, waiting. And this was the news was brought on the market. Everybody said, oh, zero cash is going moon. But it isn't. Because zero cash is always retracing, and that's what I said you already twice in previous webinars. It's always making deep retracings. And if I watch here, oh, TradingView is really annoying today. If we take a simple Fibonacci, it made enough, more or less, but maybe it's going to the 76, and that's somewhere around here, I think. Yeah. Trust. I think Trust already did one, two, three, four, five correction. This correction might be this towards maybe this trend line. What I said, guys, I didn't prepare this very well, so I'm a little bit drawing now. But this is what I see. breaking out of this pattern. And retesting. And it can retest because I did already a 5 text move, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now ABC correction till here. And then it's starting leg number 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 towards here. So if I post this on trading view and I mention showing you this chart or this target, it won't go there in one straight line, guys. Never forget, you will always have corrections. And let me see, pivot. No, well, more or less the same. Breakout of this pattern, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's not. If I was a pure 100% Elliott wave follower, then this wasn't correct. Maybe it'll have another pattern for it, but I see a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a ABC. And it might bounce from this area. Oh, we're on the daily. That's a big one. look, it's getting pretty close and now trying to break out. Watch it, guys. If this one breaks out here, it might go. And of course, again, with some correction, it goes up. Somebody asking for store. I looked at store, but it wasn't really exciting what I saw. I didn't see. Well, it was this morning, I think, but that didn't look very spectacular for me. Welcome coin, that was a nice one. And why? Maybe you saw it on Twitter. I bought this coin this week. Where's my mouse? Okay, I bought this coin this week because some of the members in our trading room who lives in Asia was very enthusiastic and he spent us and he's a very good fundamental guy and he convinced me that I should buy it and I bought it at here it is. It was, I think, my mouse is disappearing. You see, there it is. I think I bought something here. Here at 60, 80, and 90, I think. Sold it yesterday night. It's lagging again, guys, so I'll try to do it like this. I sold it here, and because I was it was pretty tough to chart this, but I did it more or less manual, and told my guys in the room that it would be around 170 where it should reverse, and it came to 168, more or less. So when I saw dropping here, I saw this candle, the middle one, was for me to sign that it would go down, and I bought somewhere here again, 120, 125, because this already finished, was a finished 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 move, followed by ABC correction here, ABC. Now going up again. So this might make a big move again, guys. Be prepared. That's it for me, my watch list, more or less. Any requests? I'll do five. Give me five requests. Buy and sell walls. Yeah, we'll do it after. Iota, Steam. Steam broke out, I think. Okay. I'm wondered why it's not Steam on my own. Because I am in Steam. It's not on my watch list. You see, I'm not chilling my own bags, guys. It's not on the list. And I'm in it. Okay. Breaking out, it's breaking out here. And it's touched this box. But you see what I draw here? Let's make it a bit more visible. For me, it's in a flat correction. But I think, it might go here, and maybe another leg down before up. So keep your eyes on that trend line. One, two, three, four. I wouldn't be surprised if this goes up from here or a bit later, but this is, it will break here, either here or here or here, but this goes at least to here. It's not a really spectacular move, but watch this area. If it breaks out here and gets here, watch this area, what it's doing. If it's showing bearish move, sell it. If you are in, because we can very good make another leg down before continuing further up. Do I have a target? No, no targets here. Let me check. No. Yeah, it's more or less important what's happening here. And looking at this, normally I would say it's a down move where is a little bit of correction, but it might go back to this area. It was more or less already there. No. It might very well be possible that we get one more leg up, down to this area, and then bounce up. So if this goes here, if it breaks out here, don't blindly buy it because it's going up. First, watch this area. Strap this, I see. So we'll look. Oh, what's happening here? I could drop it here, but I'm not that. Because I'm working, thinking about zones, I'm not that very precise on this. This feels for me like going down. It's looking for the bottom again. You see? I already explained this week that this was pretty much disappointing. New wallet release and it's going back. back then. And this is also a pattern which we discussed earlier today. You see, down, consolidation here, going down more. And I'm on the 4 hour, let me see on the 1 hour. Yeah. It's more or less for me, it's like this. Oh, people are selling while I'm speaking. Yeah, big down move. This is an impulsive move, and after this impulsive move, we get a consolidation. And this should go, or not should, this is going, normally it's going down here to find, to look again for the support line. And this is a target which I have already for months, 80. I wouldn't be surprised if you get there. I want to get there. I want to be right. So for now, nothing to see more or less in Stratis. Though, if you are in, then you should know that count on it that if we are at 110 more or less, and then we could even drop to 80. That's well. I don't have a crystal ball. Altcoins can be tricky, but this is just what I see. Fia mentioned quantum. QT. No, I already looked at it once, a while ago, I think. That was also a nice example that I never check fundamentals or Bitcoin talk or any other white papers or roadmaps. This week we were talking in our trader room about Walton Coin, WTC. And then I wrote in chat, guys, what kind of coin is it, this ETC? It's WTC. I had no idea. I just bought it and because the chart looked amazing good. And what do I have here? Yeah. Okay. This is what I see, guys. The pennant. Breaking out, retest here. I mentioned it already 20 times today. Retest of the channel and going up now. Smaller time frame. This, yeah. I'm just checking, guys. Yeah, this is up move, correction, breakout. Well, this was already breakout, but we had a retest. But this should break out to the upside. To where? Times two, times three, I think. Should be doable. If there is, well, it's not a thing what that is not natural or guaranteed, but it should be supported with good news. developments from the team, then followed with a pump, then a times two, times three should be doable. Let me drink a bit. Okay, I see some questions about mothership. I can't chart a mothership because I had a account on it's called the Coinigy, but I didn't like it to work on it, and that's the only place where I can chart a mothership, and my account is closed now, so I can't chart it. Mothership is more or less for me that I have a bag of it, and this morning or yesterday I bought some extra. There was a dip, a correction, but it will. It's just a long-term hold or mid-term. Wait for it. If you have it, just keep it in your bag and wait till there is coming some developments or when it's listed on a bigger exchange. It's more or less the same goes for 0x. Where do I have it? This is more or less the same. It's retracing and not, it's made a breakout, and this is also bullish. This will go again, but this might also fall here a bit more and more, and it's just waiting. Be patient. And same is for 0x as for mothership. They need some developments or listings on other exchanges like Bittrex. Then we certainly will see a movement. 0x is at the moment only on Poloniex. Mothership is only on Cryptopia. They just need a bigger exchange with more volume, and then they might start moving. Further on, what I wanted to speak with you guys about is buy and sell walls, because I see many times that people get scared about buy and sell walls, and I don't. I use them. Because you shouldn't look at what the whales are doing. You should think what like a whale. If you see a sell wall of 20, 30 bitcoins, then go start thinking about why is there a sell wall? Is that nobody's putting down a sell wall of 30 bitcoins because he wants to sell those bitcoins? Those 30 bitcoins. No, because he wants to push the price. And then you should check the order book. Let me get an order book. Graag gedaan, Kim. Well, if a Dutch lady starts or a woman starts to talk to me, then I have to respond, of course. You know that, guys. Come on. Let me see. Do we know any? Is anyone of you watching a coin right now where is some action? Ardor, yeah, that's there's a lot of whales in. That's correct. Let me see here. Yeah. This is also one. Check this. 7 bitcoins, 3 bitcoins. This one could be a real seller that somebody wants to sell. But I think 8 bitcoins you're not gonna put here 8 bitcoins because you want to sell it. Let me see what is the price doing. You see, I have the new layout. You already have it, guys. You can download it, and then you get the trading view charts on Bittrex. It's very nice. It works much better. Which one, Polly? Order book has crazy sell wall. Which one? Google? No, not Google. Waves. Okay, we'll check Waves later. What can I see here? Yeah, it's. This is a tricky one because it's going down, and there are some sell walls. They are not that big, but they might be big enough. Look at this. You see here, there is not much buy support here in the beginning. Here's a bit more, but it's not convincing. Look. 5 for all small orders, and here way more big orders. And then I look always, and I look at the end, I see 30, and I see here only 10, 11. That means for me that they are pushing the price down, and you don't need a lot of sell orders to bring other people to sell. And here are people buying, and then I look always at the bigger orders which are lying here. Then it's telling me that somebody wants to buy here, and it might be very well that this guy is the same as this guy. Now, is Omisgo not the best example, because I'm expecting more downside, but it still might be that whales are buying here, and maybe even a bit lower, because they want to pump it, and then they start buying here already. Let me see, is there the daily? Yeah, look at this. This is not even such a big downfall. If it's making a pretty normal correction. A, B, C. You see? That means that whales can start buying here, and they are pushing the price down because more and more people get nervous. And then it's not much needed to bring the price down. You see, you know, they put down here the 7 Bitcoin order. It's now here, and sales are happening here. People get nervous. They start selling, and this kind of orders, like here, and you can see it, it's flashing, that are orders from bots. And there's just someone big is working with a bot, and he's putting in buy orders, and he's grabbing up. Maybe we are now at 235, maybe he will have many more orders like that all the way down to 210 or 200. But they are gathering now their orders. The buy orders, and you can find them everywhere in the order book. Mostly the bigger orders, but they are not that big that it's a buy support. But they are always as from half a Bitcoin, 1 Bitcoin, 2 Bitcoin. They're putting them in the order book just to gather the Bitcoins, because those guys, they don't think in 2 or 5 Bitcoins. They work with 200, 300 Bitcoins. And you see, if this order, if they lose a bit here, if it's going to 3 or it's completely bought up, they don't bother, because these guys they work with this pattern, and you are looking at this, and you're looking, oh, we're going down. They are looking at this, and they are looking at the, they are going to buy all the coins or as much as possible till here, something. Then they are going to pump it. You are nervous on this chart, and you will see, I showed you also earlier today that we're in a bearish flag. You see, I never tried charting on this one. Wow. I got it. Hey. Oh, it was a white line, maybe. I showed you more or less something like this. And I told you, oh, it's going down. And you freak out and think, oh my God, it's going to 230, 220. It's a big drop. Yeah, because you are looking on a very small time frame. Look here, it's nothing. It's such a small move. You see, it's my line which I draw, it's, I can't find it almost. It's here. You see, this is my line. So you're on a very small time frame. Are you always watching what the price is doing? I'm pretty sure many people are watching the 5 minutes. But come on, you make yourself nervous. Don't do that. Think like a whale and look at the bigger picture. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep. And then A, B, C. And they will buy your coins here. You will freak out. Maybe there is some more FUD. Maybe the Republic of Congo is closing altcoins next week, and you all start to panic and sell, and you're gonna buy back later when it's even when it's bouncing already. That's what I say. Think like a whale. This the bigger picture, and don't freak out when it's going a bit more down. Take the example of waves, because that is a example where it's going up. Waves was breaking out, and we had this, earlier this webinar, we had this big spike. That was a big buy, and look at this son of a bitch. It's this guy, I'm pretty sure. So buying 30, 40 Bitcoin of waves. Now he has enough, and now he's pushing down the price because he wants more. He wants 50 or he wants 80. So he's pushing down here, and you see here, these are his orders. And then I try to find if I can look, then see all again here a 4 Bitcoin. This was a 4 Bitcoin. This is maybe this is some already sold into. And he's watching the webinar because he's removing it now. You see? but I look for these orders if I can find them, and then I'll try to, I just know that for me, this is very clear. Somebody's pushing the price because he wants to buy back lower. And maybe he was this, he bought here, he put them right away, straight away in the selling position, and he doesn't bother. If people start buying from him, if he is a pro, then he wouldn't bother, because if he sells here if they buy about 3-4 bitcoins, he doesn't bother because he's gonna buy more here. He keeps pushing down, I promise you. And you see, this one is maybe also his, that he's protecting his wall here, and he's just waiting to till the people he dropped it. You see, maybe he's got enough, but or he's coming back a bit lower, you don't know. But in this way, the whales are trying to push down the price, and don't panic for that. If I see a sell wall, then I think it's positive. These kind of sell walls are positive for me, because I know that somebody wants to get in. He wants to buy lower, and then I know that a big player wants to buy more. And I don't think about, oh, the price is going down because there's a sell wall. No, I think in the end we will go up because somebody's interested and he wants to buy more. And okay, I accept that we don't go straight up one line as from now. No, maybe we will go tomorrow, but we will go up because somebody who is buying a shitload of waves, if he's buying here 30, 40 bitcoins and he's pushing down the price now, I know it's going to go up. It's maybe not today, maybe it's tomorrow or next week, but it will go. They have enough power that if they buy straight from the order book here 30, 50 bitcoins, then they have plans, and they have plans to push this way further up. And think about it like that. And if you see sell walls, don't get scared. You have to get scared when you see a sell wall here and a buy wall here. If you are, let me take the example of, well, I can take this. Imagine this is a very long, this is, oh, wait, I'll take OMG. Check this. This is a very long up move. And once you are already made this big rise, and well, I can see here definitely already the patterns, what would tell me at that time that it's going, that it would make correction. But if you already have such a long up move, and when you are in this area, and you would see in the order book, you would see here a big order for let me say 20 bitcoins sell order, and you see here a buy order for 40 bitcoins, then it's getting tricky, because this 40 bitcoins buy order, what could be here, is pushing up the price into his sell order. Because you are on the end of a long rise, you're ending a cycle. So don't think that this 40 bitcoins is bringing you to the moon. Nobody will bring you to the moon. That 40 bitcoin is just to push up the price, and so that you are going to buy his sell order. If you have such a big buy order and you see a smaller sell order, I guarantee you there is somebody pushing up the price, that and you all get excited, and you are all going into the troll boxes where you are 20 hours a day. You're going to start talking about Lambos and trying to find some pictures of the moon to post them on Twitter. Not gonna happen, guys. Then it's just a big player who is pushing up the price so that you're all going to buy his sell order, what is on this side. So That's it more or less for today, third webinar. And it wasn't, of course, all to tell you a little bit more about how I'm thinking, how I work, what is my vision of the market, and to bring some action attention for my new service, which is going to be live next week. It's the Market Watch, what we did this week, will be as from Sunday. We will do it four times a week. Not me alone, but I have a team with some other guys that will do this in four times a week. And we are building a Slack community where members can join and discuss with other members of the Market Watch. You can discuss whatever you want. You can talk about new coins, old coins, about BTC, about coming ICOs. You can, if you want, you can go in the off-topic channel to talk about football or soccer. And we are also representing, or we are also present in that channel. We are sharing our charts for the days that we are not broadcasting. We are giving signals, short-term signals, with some explanation, because I don't want to be a signal service, because that's not my style. But like I do now, then I can explain what why I think something is happening. And besides that, then we have four times a week. We do this webinar for 3 times. Is it short term? And then in the weekends, I do a webinar for the market view for a whole week, or the bigger picture. And then 3 times a week, we look for 1 day, 2 days in front, what I expect, what's happening. And of course, for people who are only trading Bitcoin, it's also I'm going then into detail with the bigger coins, and even on, you know, onto the 60 or the 15 minutes chart. And I will invite you to visit my site to watch what I'm offering, and I hope it's interesting for you, and I'm sure you can learn a lot, and I'm pretty sure that you can make some profit, or a good profit. If you look at the contribution fee, it's not that much. It should be very doable to win that very soon, very quick, and to make it that your payment is not a cost, but it is an investment in higher gains. People asking me if I stop Twitter? No, absolutely not. I surely stay on Twitter and on TradingView because I have fun showing you what I think. And I still keep doing also trainings because I enjoy it to learn the people, and I see myself as an old fox in this world, in the crypto scene. I have some experience, and I see a lot of people coming in who have no experience at all, and they heard from the neighbor, or from in the grocery, they heard that you can order Lambos at crypto scene. It's not going to work like that. It's a very tricky scene. I have the feeling that so many people want more information. And I'm happy to share that. And if you learn from me, I'm happy. If you decide to join my group, I'm also happy. But if you don't, no problem. I will keep posting. But on Twitter and TradingView, for instance, if I give a call on Twitter, you can be sure it was first sent out to the members of my trading room. So I think it's very interesting to consider joining it. If you do, I would be very happy and looking forward to meet you then. If you have questions, please visit my site and use the mail, the contact site over there, and send me a mail, and I'll respond very quickly. So more or less, that's it for today and for this week. If you have any questions, please ask them on my site or on Twitter, and I'll be happy to help you. Thanks a lot, guys, for viewing and for the nice comments. And if I don't see you in my trader room, we'll meet in TradingView or on Twitter. Bye bye. Thanks.